interaction. Well, blood flow restriction therapy is growing in popularity and can really help patients with leg or arm injuries recover much faster. But as 11 News reporter Theo Hayes found out, it needs to be done properly.
A little bit, yeah.
Three times a week for an hour, Emily Berner has therapy to heal her ACL. She tore it while playing lacrosse, and her physical therapist recommended using blood restriction therapy post-surgery.
It allows us to get some really good strength gains without actually, say, lifting 50 pounds for a shoulder press or, you know, lifting 300 pounds for a leg press, something like that.
During the therapy, this tourniquet-like device is placed over the muscle, restricting blood flow while small movements are made.
Sometimes your toes can get a little bit tingly, not in like a bad way.
Emily is getting her strength back without compromising the injury, and the restricted blood vessels cause the body to pump hormones that promote healing, something Berner is eager for so she can get back onto the field.
I think the protocol is no running until week 12, and then return to play is about 8 to 12 months, so it's a long recovery.
Blood restriction therapy is growing in popularity even at gyms, but doing it without a healthcare provider is not recommended.
Some people out there that might be tying some bands around their arms, and the unfortunate thing about that is you're not able to regulate the pressure as well. A lot of times it's a little narrower than you would like, and it's not an FDA-listed device.
Berner is hopeful she'll heal in time for the senior season this fall. Theo Hayes, WBAL TV 11 News. All right.